On this hot summer afternoon outside Brattleboro, Vermont, farmer Dean Hamilton has fired up his tractor and is fertilizing his hayfield with human urine. That's right, pee. Now, I know what you're thinking, but it's not really gross. It's ultimately about making our water cleaner and our agriculture more sustainable.
I've been surprised at how many people actually get beyond the giggle factor pretty quickly and are willing to listen.
This field has also been fertilized with urine.
This is a place where we can take a lot of fertilizer products and test them out.
This lettuce is destined for the lab, not the market. So too for water samples they collect from the soil. With support from the National Science Foundation, environmental engineer Nancy Love and a team that includes the nonprofit Rich Earth Institute are fine-tuning new methods to recycle urine into fertilizer.
There's a great quote by Buckminster Fuller about how pollution is nothing but the resources that we're not harvesting and that we allow them to disperse because we've been ignorant to their value.
Fertilizer is made of nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus that require huge amounts of energy to produce. Urine is full of those same nutrients, but we literally flush them down the toilet.
What we want to do is we want to fix two problems at once. Create fertilizer that can then sustain our agriculture and at the same time eliminate waste on the one hand and the need to mine and create fertilizer on the other hand.
The Rich Earth Institute has been using urine as fertilizer since 2012. They collect about 7,000 gallons a year thanks to a loyal group of dedicated donors.
We now have people who have some source separating toilets in their homes. We also have people who have 55-gallon barrels where they collect and then we transport to our farms. And we've also got a large urine depot.
Their method so far has been to pasteurize it to kill any microbes and then apply it directly onto hay fields. Now that they've partnered with Love and her team, they're looking to go to the next level.
There are three things we really are trying to do with the urine in this kind of next phase. We're trying to concentrate it, we're trying to apply technologies to reduce odor, and we're trying to deal with the trace contaminants like the pharmaceuticals.
The pharmaceuticals issue is an important one that they are working hard to understand better. Heating up urine kills germs, but doesn't have any effect on chemicals like drugs that pass through our bodies.
We know pharmaceuticals are a problem for aquatic organisms in water systems. It's debatable about the impact on human health at very, very low levels. Independent of that, I think most people would prefer that they not be in their food. And so we are taking the steps to remove them from these products.
For Love, this is all about redesigning our wastewater infrastructure for the 21st century. Too many nutrients in the water leads to poor water quality by causing hazardous algal blooms.
Our water emissions are going into very sensitive water bodies that are vulnerable to these nutrient loads. We need to change that dynamic, and if we can capture them and put them to a beneficial use, that's what we're trying to do.
Recycling urine into fertilizer to make agriculture greener and our waterways cleaner. For Science Nation, I'm Miles O'Brien.